It is my very great pleasure to introduce your judge for the working group, Mrs. Kari Wilbur, escorted into the ring by Mr. Gerald King, Chairman of France. Kari, originally from Norway, moved to the UK with her husband Sigurd in 1981, and together they had established as big a name in the UK for their Kamek's kennel as they had established in their native Norway. Having made up 50 champions in the UK, Kari awards challenge certificates in 9 breeds and is approved to judge the working, pastoral group, and also best in show at championship show level. So ladies and gentlemen, once more, a big hand for your working group judge, Kari Wilbur. And the first of the dogs for Kari to look at is the Alaskan Malamute. The Burmese Mountain Dog. The Bouvier de Flandre. The Boxer. The Bull Mastiff. The Canadian Eskimo Dog. The Doberman. The Dog de Bordeaux. The German Pinscher. The Giant Schnauzer. The Great Dane. The Greenland Dog. The Hogabart. The Leonberger. The Mastiff. The Neapolitan Mastiff. The Newfoundland. The Portuguese Water Dog. The Rottweiler. The Russian Black Terrier. The St. Bernard. The Siberian Husky. And making up a full group, the Tibetan Mastiff. Ladies and gentlemen, I now hand over to Graham Hill for the working group commentary DFS Cross 2011.
Thank you, Jonathan. Well, another good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Here we are at the climax of today's group judging, of course. The first group we judge here, on this, the second day of DMS Cups 2011, is this working group. There are 23 breeds represented here in the big ring. This is the second of the 7 groups of dog breeds to be exhibited and judged over the 4 days here at DMS Cups 2011. The winner of this group being one of the finalists who will compete here in a best in show ring on Sunday evening. We already have one of our finalists, that golden retriever from yesterday, Gundogan. The working group is made up of dogs that have been selectively bred over the centuries to assist man in a number of different tasks, such as guarding, working as a draft dog, or a rescue dog. almost all the working dogs, as we can see here in the main ring, are large, strong, and muscular animals. They are invariably intelligent and can be trained to perform useful tasks. And this group contains some of the bravest and most heroic dogs in the canine world. It is largely these qualities that make such an excellent guard dog and rescue dog. And this the working group contains some of the most popular dog breeds. And now that Mrs. Carrie Woolworth has completed her first walk around the ring, taking in her first phase of the working group rescue breeds, she goes to commence her individual examination of each of the breeds, starting with the Alaskan Malamute. Here we see that our best breed, Alaskan Malamute. This breed was judged today by Mr. S.J. Mallard. Mr. Mallard selected this male. Dog number 5042 is his best breed from an entry of 188, made by 162 Alaskan Malamutes. This breed originated in the United States of America. Alaska Malamute was named after the Malamute Inuit Eskimos. This green breed was used to pull heavy loads long before European visits to the Americas. Although wolf-like in appearance, the Alaskan Malamute is an affectionate dog and a devoted companion. That's our best breed, Alaskan Malamute, number 5042. Now we move on to our Bernese Mountain Dog. It was a re-entry of 223, made by 200 Bernese Mountain Dogs. And re-judge Mr. T.N. Monroe selected this male, dog number 5201, as his best breed. The Bernese Mountain Dog originated in Switzerland and is another ancient breed, which probably was introduced into Switzerland by the Roman soldiers 2,000 years ago. Swiss dogs. It was used by the weavers of Bern to pull heavy loads and also employed in Bernese shearing cattle. Our best was the Bernese Mountain Dog 5201. And next to be seen is the Bouvier de Fond. Mr. T. Simmons was the breed judge today. And there was a re-entry of 57 made by 54 Bouviers. Mr. Simmons selected this male. Dog number 5358 as his best breed. The origins of the breed are from the areas of Belgium and France. This robust cattle droving, cart pulling farm dog existed in a number of coats and color varieties until 1965, when the present standard was written. Still aboard, and as our youth bouvier in his medical corps, and also as a military messenger. The Bouvier de Flandre was first shown in Brussels in 1910. This is our best breed, Bouvier de Flandre, dog number 5358. And now we see our best breed, Boxer. There were two judges for Boxers today. Males were judged by Mr. E.A. Banks and bitches by Mrs. H. Banks, the husband and wife team. There were 197 boxers entered, and they jointly selected this male for their best breed, exhibit number 5433. This breed originated in Germany in the 1850s and was first used for guarding and bull baiting. This is a hardy breed, full of stamina. This is a breed standard for the boxer. This was issued in Germany in 1995. And the name may be derived from Bullenbeister, which means bullfighter. Olympic boxer, number 5433. And now we move on to the bull mastiff. This is M.C. Boston, who is the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 130 made by 125 bull mastiffs. And Mrs. Rossman selected this bitch who has the breed, number 5597. This is a breed that originated here in Great Britain around 1800. And it was developed from 60% English mastiff, 40% bulldog, and was produced to act as a gamekeeper's assistant with the ability to chase and immobilize poachers on large estates. Naturally intelligent and observant, he is easily trained, likes to have a reason for doing things. Makes a good companion, totally reliable both physically and mentally. Our best of breed bull mastiff, number 5597. And here we see the Canadian Eskimo dog. Mr. G.C. Rule, judge the breed, here at the FS Cups 2011. There was a breed entry of 20, and he selected this male for his best of breed, dog number 5728. Originating in Canada thousands of years ago, this dog has been the only means of transportation for the Inuit Eskimos, living in what are the Nunavut and the Northern Territories of Canada. Today it's still used for sled pulling and sled racing. The Canadian Eskimo dog does everything, eating, working, sparring, and arguing, always with an abundant energy. It's our best of breed, Canadian Eskimo 5728. And here you see our best of breed, Doberman. Again, this breed had two judges, another husband and wife team. This is I, Rushford, judge the males, and Mr. Fay Rushford, the bitches. There's a total breed entry of 199, made by 178 Dobermans. And they selected this male for their best of breed, dog number 5870. Beginning in the 1870s, a German tax collector named Louis Doberman used the Rottweiler, German Pinscher, Weimaraner, English Greyhound, and Manchester Terrier to develop this breed. Germany just over 100 years ago. The Doberman is intelligent and firm of character, loyal and obedient. Our best would be Doberman 5870. Now we have the Dog de Bordeaux. There was a breed entry of 140 made by 132 Dog de Bordeaux. The breed judge, Mr. A. Bignall, selected this as bitch for us to breed. Exhibit number 6030. The dog of order originates in France as a breed of great antiquity. The breed is closer to the recently developed bull mastiff than to the ancient English mastiff. This is a very old breed, which is originally used for boar and bear hunting in South France. Our best of breed, Dr. Bordeaux, number 6030. And here we see the German Pinscher. This was a breed judged today by Mr. S.J. Mallard. And Mr. Mallard selected this male best of breed from an entry of 23. His number is 6044. It's a forebear of the miniature Pinscher who played a role in the development of the Doberman. Our best would be German Pinscher, number 6044. And now we see the giant schnauzer. Mrs. J. Rule was the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 65. And she selected this male for her best of breed, number 6112. This is the largest and most powerful of the German schnauzers. This reliable dog was developed by increasing the size of the standard schnauzer. It originated around the Middle Ages and was the commonly used herding breed in southern Germany. And here we see the Great Dane. This was a breed purchased by Mr. R.A.W. Searle, and he selected this bitch for best of breed, number 6224. That was for an entry of 176, made by 162 Great Danes. The dignified but affectionate Great Dane is the national dog of Germany. It has been since 1876. Came to Britain the following year. The Great Dane has been used as a war dog, a large mammal hunting dog, but is mainly used today as a companion or guardian dog. Best of breed Great Dane, number 6224. Now we move on to the Greenland dog. This was another breed judged today by Mr. G.C. Rule. There was an entry of 3, and Mr. Rule selected this male for best of breed, number 6291. The ancestry of this breed can possibly be traced back to dogs accompanying people from Siberia well over 12,000 years ago. The Greenland dog is not as heavy as the Canadian Eskimo dog, but is often slightly taller. This is a breed that has been used for sled pulling, guarding, and a watchdog. Today it's used for sled racing and hunting in Norway. Best of breed Greenland dog, number 6291. And now we move on to the Hobbelhaupt. The Jackie Bispel was the three judge today. There was a breed entry of 37, made by 34 Hobbelhaupts, and Mr. Bispel selected his male for his best of breed. His number is 6316. This is another breed of considerable antiquity, having been known for many centuries as a guard dog, mainly from farmyard. The breed hails from the Black Forest region of Germany and was first recognized by the German Kennel Club in 1936. The breed has only been seen in the UK in the last decade or so, is only now emerging as a truly recognizable breed. This is our best of breed Hobbelhaupt, number 6316. Now we see our best of breed Leonberger. Mr. Frank Kane judged the breed here at the FS Trust 2011, and from an entry of 178, made by 155 Leonbergers, Mr. Kane selected his male for his best of breed, number 6429. The breed is a strikingly handsome dog, an easy, eager, and natural swimmer. He's willing to dog travel in the coldest of weather. This genial giant almost became extinct during World War II, but in the last 25 years or so, it's gained a good foothold both here and its home country of Germany. Resembling the lion on the imperial coat of arms from the town Hall of Leonberg in Germany, whose Valencia, Newfoundland, St. Bernard, and the Pyrenean Mountain Dog to create this distinguished breed. That's to bring your burger 6429. And here we see the Mastiff, Miss H.A. Sargent, was the breed judge. And she selected this bitch for best breed from the entry of 40. Her number is 6513. The Mastiff existed in Great Britain 2,000 years ago. Was exported to Rome as a military dog and a fighting dog. The name probably evolved from the Anglo-Saxon word "masti," meaning powerful. This is one of the largest dogs in the world and requires ample space to live in, of course, large quantities of food. Our best would be Mastiff. Number 6513. And now we move on to the Neapolitan Mastiff. Mr. L.M. the Pinto Tixiero is the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 40. Mr. Pinto Tixiero selected his female bull as the breed, number 6589. The Neapolitan Mastiff was present in Campania in central Italy since ancient times, but not exhibited until 1947. This breed probably descended from the Roman fighting, war, and circus mastiffs. Strongly built, a very majestic bearing, is a devoted and loyal guard of both owner and property. That's to be Neapolitan Mastiff 6589. Now we come to the Newfoundland. It was a breed entry of 224 made by 206 Newfoundlands. This is a Merrick, who is the breed judge, selected this bitch for best breed, number 6657. The breed originated in Canada in the 1700s. And here we have one of the friendliest of all the breeds. And we found that it was originally used in cod fisheries to pull nets ashore and to pull boats. Britain, the breed was first shown in 1860 and recognized by the Canada in 1878. A devoted companion with an exceptionally gentle, docile nature. Our best of breed Newfoundland, number 6657. Now we see our best of breed Portuguese water dog. This is another breed, judged today by Mr. L.M.B. Pinto Tixeira, who's coming from Portugal. With the seal of DFS Crust 2011. And Mr. Pinto Tixeira selected this bitch for best breed exhibit number 6801 from an entry 52. As this breed, the breed's name implies, originates in Portugal. This was sometime in the Middle Ages. Portuguese water dog was an ancient breed of fisherman's dog, used to pull nets in the water and to take messages from boat to boat. On land, it was a useful hunting dog that was used to hunt rabbits. Our best of breed, Portuguese water dog number 6801. And now we see our best of breed, Rottweiler. One of the breeds that seems to receive a large entry. The working group had two judges. Males were judged by Ms. R. Meadley, and bitches by Mrs. Zenith Bourne Andrews. It was a breed entry of 310, made by 272 Rottweilers. And our judges selected this bitch for best of breed, number 7031. The Rottweiler was bred in Rottweiler, South Germany, in the 1800s. Well, I'm just going to go to the new Okay, this is Tessa Hansen's dog, the descendant of an ancient boar hunter. He is popular throughout the world as both family dog and guard dog. Our best between Rottweiler, number 7031. Russian Black Terrier is another breed judged by Mr. Alan V. Pinto Gixiera. And we selected this bitch for best of breed, number 7174, from an entry of 37. This breed is a relevant newcomer to the show in the United Kingdom. The breed was developed, obviously, in Russia, by the Soviet Union's Red Star Army Canids in the 1940s. This was by crossing the giant schnauzer, Airedale Terrier, Rottweiler, and perhaps other breeds. Russian Black Terrier, number 7174. And moving on, we now come to our best of breed, St. Bernard. Mr. T. Gerling is the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 86 made by 84 St. Bernards. And Mr. Gerling selected this picture of best of breed, number 7193. St. Bernard is arguably the most famous dog. The rescue dogs. The Bernardine Hospice has kept this family breed since the 1660s, and the Bernardine monks use the breed for pulling heavy loads and boasted of its hauling abilities. Today's benevolent help is an impressive muscular giant. St. Bernard named Barry was responsible for saving the lives of 40 travelers. This is our best of breed, St. Bernard, number 7193. Now we come to the Siberian Husky. This is Anne Arch, who's the breed judge today. There was a breed entry of 252, 212 Siberian Huskies. And this is Arch selected this male for the best of breed, number 7316. This is a breed smaller and lighter than most other breeds of set dog. The elegant Siberian Husky is agile, athletic, and a tireless worker. He uses a drop dog by the diplomatic Eskimos. The Siberian Husky was just born in the 19th century by the fur traders and brought to North America in 1909. That's the breed Siberian Husky 7316. And we now come to the final breed of the working group, preceded by Mrs. Wilberg, the Tibetan Mastiff. The breed was judged today by Mr. L. N. B. Pinto Teixeira. And it was a breed entry of 50. Mr. Pinto Teixeira selected his male for this breed, number 7477. Tibetan Mastiff obviously originated in Tibet many, many centuries ago. This breed once protected livestock from the Himalayas and Tibet, but now a European bred show dog, still uncommon but established throughout Europe. Easy going, after the evolution, Tibetan Mastiff is content to be one of life's observers. Though it will not hesitate to defend what it feels to be home territory. Most European Mastiffs are descended from Tibetan Mastiffs. Our Tibetan Mastiff, best of breed, number 7477. Examinations of each of the working breeds present here in the group ring. As is the usual practice, you will make another walk around the ring. in order to have another cursory look at each of the rings. This will enable her to finalize her opinion and evaluation of each breed and to judge and assess their breed qualities, fitness and condition, attendant to their individual breed standards. These 25 or 23 best breeds have fit finalists from the overall working group entry of 2,766, made by 2,500 working groups. Shortlist, usually around 8 breeds, for a day in the community. Okay, we have some animals. The Indian Shorter, the Boxer, the Doberman, the German Pitcher, the Newfoundland, the Portuguese Waterdog, the Rottweiler. And we have our 8 shortest breeds, so I ask you to show your appreciation and congratulate our other best breeds here at the Women's Group and for the win and the success here at the DFS Press 2011. And our address, this is Kelly Woodward. We'd like to shake the hand of each of our Women's Group best breeds as they leave the ring. So we have our final shortlist, the date of the working breeds, the Aspen Malamute, the Bouvier de Fond, the Boxer, the Doberman, the German Pinscher, the Newfoundland, the Portuguese Waterdog, and the Rottweiler. Across the ring, I'm sure, again, as the norm, she will move each of these shortest breeds again. The first of our shortest to be moved is the here goes the Alaskan Malamute. And now the Bouvier de Flandre. Number 5358, being judged today by Mr. T. Simmons. We're happy to meet you, sort of group, I suppose. Now here goes the Doberman. We're joined today by Mrs. I. Rushberg, or Mrs. I. Rushberg, and Mr. K. Rushberg. This is number 5870. And now here goes the German Fincher, 6-0-4-4. We've just led by Mr. Chester Hammer.
And
working group 4, the Rottweiler, 7031. Can I ask our winners to do their letter bottom, please? That off by the winner of the working group, the EFS Cross 2011, the Boxer.